flow. I like to let it flow. My lives, I like to let it flow. But I've been doing a lot of, past couple days I've been doing, I know you haven't seen me live, I've been doing a lot of healing work on myself, my mind, and I noticed some things, and you know, like I said, my life is constantly changing, evolving. As I apply my own knowledge to my life is constantly changing and evolving. So if you see me, you might be like, oh my God, this guy's confused, he's unstable, he's undysfunctional. Well, life will make you seem like that when you're in a learning, constant growing. It'll make you seem like you're just unstable, like you're going from one thing to another. So, recently I had let my wives go, and, you know, I seen that they were more fit with somebody else, and I'm now by myself. And in the process of that, I did that because I felt like I was doing polygamy wrong, in a sense. And I learned from my mistakes through my experience. Like I told you, I've been applying the knowledge to my life. So that's the best way to learn. And the master has failed more than the student can ever even imagine succeeding. So if you ain't out here learning, if you ain't out here applying that knowledge to yourself, failing, then you're not going to become the master or get no real wisdom. Because a lot of us is just trying to conceptualize things that are supposed to be experienced. And so, you know, it's good to get out here and apply that knowledge, especially in the information age where we have all this knowledge. So right now, I decided to start fresh, start new. And I evaluated myself, my actions, and I made a lot of mistakes. And I'm starting over. So we had a big meeting. You know, let Aya and Ra go. As you know, Eliana left with my daughter, and then I just decided to start over with my building of polygamy. I feel like I did it wrong. The truth about the matter is, I have some weaknesses in my chart. I have commitment issues, right? What that means is, I've been hurt a lot in my life by a woman, and I've had to evaluate that myself and look at it and accept the fact that, you know, I'm scared to get my heart broke. Because every time when I was younger, when I was dealing with a woman, I opened my heart completely, and I was like just completely, you know, open and vulnerable, and I was hurt couple of times, and it turned me into someone that used, you know, being with a lot of women as a way to protect myself from being hurt, being vulnerable in a relationship. So I realized I've been abusing polygamy, right? But using it as a scapegoat to face my inner vulnerabilities, and so this is why I let it go right now. And now I'm just opening up to the universe to send me into a monogamous relationship. And I say this because I'm still polygamous by nature, but I don't think that you can be polygamous truly without being committed and open and vulnerable into a monogamous relationship first. So I realized this, that in practicing it the wrong way, I realized how to do it the right way. And basically, you have to be with that first wife monogamously, completely committed, without any, you know, when I get scared in a relationship, I tend to start making myself available to other women, and I had used that as polygamy, and it was until, you know, recently that I realized my own flaw and my own mistake, and I was like, wow, like, I'm using this shit as an scapegoat from running from myself and being vulnerable in a relationship. You see, when I was with Eliana, I wasn't fulfilled because she was a little younger than me, and I felt like she wasn't, like, maybe woman enough for me. And so I used that, and women before her, you know what I'm saying? I use polygamy as that way, when the truth is no polygamous relationship can ever be successful without a successful monogamous one first. And I learned that the hard way. A lot of y'all probably already knew that. Y'all probably like, nigga, you stupid. I am stupid. Learn from my mistakes. Don't do that. If you're trying to be polygamous, please do it the right way and be totally monogamous with one woman first. Make sure that that woman is okay with polygamy, but also know that you have to establish that business first. Make sure that you establish, because I look at it as a business. Your relationship is a business. And so when you have a business, sometimes you have to give your all to one business and make sure it's complete first before you open up another one. You know what I'm saying? So the key to true successful polygamy is monogamy. So if you want to be polygamous, you must first learn how to totally commit to one partner. And so that's a very important step that I had misconstrued. And so what happened is I'm now by myself and I'm opening myself to vulnerably get involved in a monogamous relationship with someone that may come along that's compatible with me and what I'm trying to do. And just for like maybe a year, you know, like really go into a monogamous relationship completely and really work on my running. Every time I see something I don't like, I run. When I should open up for communication, I'm scared to be vulnerable with my emotions. So I just shut down and I start opening myself up to other women. And then from there, I said I'm polygamous. So I got all these women there and there's no one I'm really connecting to deeply. And so Aya is with Tron again. I know you think that we pass people around. That's okay. Rise with Solar. And they got their own journeys, you know what I'm saying? And I'm with me. And you're probably looking at my life like, oh, shit, y'all ain't stable, y'all dysfunctional. That's how you see it. That's how you see it. It's my life. I got to live it. But I hope to inspire those that are actually watching and can take something from this. Those of you can't, I apologize. You can laugh at me. If I make you laugh, at least I did something. So now, you know, I decided to open myself for, you know, monogamy first. But I'm definitely polygamous still. It's just that I want to establish that deep bond with someone first. Then we can invite or allow more energy in. But for like at least a long time, just be with one person. And I'm really a romantic person. That's another thing I've missed. I miss being romantic because I'm like a really R&B-ass thug, you know what I'm saying, type nigga. So I really am, you know, that kind of a dude, and I was neglecting myself because of my fears of opening up myself emotionally to someone. Because every time I dealt with a woman, as soon as I see that she not what I want, I started opening myself to other women, and I attract a lot of women, so the options were there. So I had a lot of women, but I was not emotionally connected to them. And so with that being stated, the next time I realized that I maybe not a good fit with that woman, I either let her go or I would dive in deeply into my emotions and talk to her about what I don't like, and maybe we can make a compromise. You go into it deeply. You see what I'm saying? So that's what I'm opening myself from the universe now. I'm ready for that. So I'm opening myself for that, and I'm ready for healing for my own journey. If you're watching, inspires you, that's good for you. But commitment, man. Commitment. It's hard. My Mars is in Libra in the 11th house. You know? You got that community dick. Shout out to all the or everybody watching out there that's a Libra. Mars in Libra. And 11th house. But my Venus is in Pisces. You know, my Venus is in Pisces in the 4th house, so I have this, you know, general love, and I'm big on communication, you know what I'm saying, and that's another thing for me, that's scary, women that are subjective. I attract, you know, subjective women to me, but I'm a very objective thinker, and so that scares me when women show to be unstable and not be able to communicate through their emotions. That always makes me start looking for another woman, and that's not right. I should just leave that woman alone completely and cut all ties rather than drag her along and play them games with her, because, you know, and I used polygamy as a scapegoat into my fears. And I've learned from that. I'm not a Libra, I'm a Taurus. My Mars is in Libra. I'm a Taurus with a Leo moon. I'm a Taurus 6th house with Leo moon in the 9th. So, you know, after being hurt in my earlier relationships, I therefore knew and adapted to not getting hurt no more. And it was like basically cutting myself off emotionally so that I won't get hurt. And that's not the way. All y'all fellas out there, as you mature, you'll realize that that ain't the way. And you probably are still polygamous, and don't get it twisted like a mango mystic. It's just that you need to first develop that first relationship with that woman very deeply. And I think relationships, especially for me, have been a catalyst for my spiritual growth. That's been that. And I'm starting this new journey by myself. And every day I've been by myself and just healing and thinking about all the mistakes that I made in relationships and people I might have hurt. And if I hurt anybody out there, just know that I'm growing and I apologize. It wasn't intentional. I didn't even know within myself that I was doing it. So, hey, I got a battery? So, moving forward through the transition, I've learned, I've been crying, I've been vulnerable, really, like, tapping into my emotional body, and just really crying, man. Crying is therapeutic, too, man. You gotta cry, to let it out, man, because sometimes you got stuff pinned in into your body. It's like muscle memory type shit. And just being alone and crying and going into your mind and healing certain circumstances and running through them. And just, you know, I use wine. I'll drink some wine and play some music. And music takes me back to certain memories and things that I've done and how I might have handled it wrong. And I forgive myself. I replay the circumstances. And the alcohol really opens up my chakras and allows me to, you know, sit with myself and deal with myself spiritually and cry, come out of that circumstance healed and know that I did what I did wrong, and then accept the fact that I didn't know and forgive myself and forgive those that hurt me as well. So it's really been a transitional for me these past 3 days. I really just haven't seen you on live. People like, Chief, go live. I'm like, nah, I'm just not in the mood. I'm healing. And so now I'm just basically opening myself to opening myself to being vulnerable and entering a relationship emotionally open, communicating, commitment, and consistency, 3 C's. So if you're trying to be polygamous, just know you need to really enter a monogamous relationship very deeply with the understanding with your partner or your companion that you are eventually going to want to go into polygamy. Make sure they know that. And, so no one's hurt about that. And, you know, shout out to everybody in the building that's going through transitions. Like I said, that Pluto.